everyone. I'm James Cebulski. Down at ice level is Ray Ferraro, and we are amped up to bring you what should be a dandy matchup here this evening. As we send it down ringside to Ray Ferraro, Ray, penalty killing, always a key going into something like this.
It is. We talked to the visiting coach today. He, in particular, stressed the need to stay out of the box. He wants his team to be aggressive, but they want to play with some discipline. It's been a little bit of a problem for them lately.
Just moments away from puck drop, both teams seem ready to go. Puck is dropped and we are underway. This has been one we've been waiting for a while, and it's time to finally see what the payoff is all about. Moves it to Jones, and now he angles it across to Pavelski. Right in front of the net! Grabbed along the boards by Doughty. Slides the puck over. Moves it quickly over to Pavelski. Blocked in traffic. And now it's grabbed by Malkin. Moves the puck. Takes the feed. Unloads the shot! And that banks off a stick. Thunder Bays across the blue line. From against the wall into the open ice. Here's a short pass to Pavelski. Quick feed down low. Great defensive effort breaking up the pass. And now he moves it quickly to Malkin. Let's it go. Stopped by the goaltender. Across the point. And a delayed penalty coming up as he got tripped up. Scooped up along the wall by Suter. Tosses it on to Malkin. And he sprints to the bench to get the extra attacker out on the ice. Comes up with the stop.
The shooter's right in the guts of the ice, but the goalie squares up, spreads out, and makes the save.
Tripping is the call. Did he sell or is that the right one in your mind?
I think it's the right one. He looks like he's picking up speed and the stick gets into his feet.
First chance of the night here on the man advantage.
And if you're one of these power play guys, James, you can't wait now. It's your first opportunity of the night. You get out on the power play, you want to make a difference.
Comes up with the stop.
Great tracking. He finds the puck. He gets the glove up, makes the save on a dangerous chance.
Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. With the blast! Puck grabbed by Subban. Trying to get it out. And a nice job by the Killers on that one.
Yeah, now they can get a change, get some fresh players on the ice.
Handles the puck. Shot shuts him down.
Goalies are always trying to get better at this. Making the save, but getting the rebound into the corner.
And that one stopped. Try and a nice job locking up his opponent and manages to clear the zone. Slides it on over to Granlund. Hammers the shot and the traffic neutralizes that threat. As they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Penalty expires. You really have to admire the effort of the penalty killing unit on that one as both teams are back to even strength.
Oh man, what a good power play, but it doesn't change the big numbers up on the score clock. Couldn't score, but all kinds of chances.
San Diego's on the attack. Big open ice hit.
As the coach told us before the game, they want to set a physical tone. There's a good hit early.
Over the line they come. Shen's going to play into the corner. Now a quick pass to Dumba. And that goes off a player in front. Takes the feed. Here's a chance. Quick shot. The Spirit have the puck against the boards. Quick pass to Konechny. Quick pass to Nyquist. Nyquist caught with the stick and the officials are signaling for a hooking penalty. And the puck stopper tags his man to get the extra attacker on the ice. Laying the body. Here comes the official's call. And he's going to get two for hooking on the play, Ray.
He should. I mean, he gets his stick out parallel to the ice. He gets it across the player's midsection, and that's kind of a red flag for that penalty.
As we're about to drop the puck, the power play unit back out onto the ice for another opportunity.
Doesn't matter whether you've had one or 10 power plays, the fundamentals of it are the same. Win the draw, get the puck to the point, try and spread the penalty killers out.
Oh, rocked along the boards! He scores!
The power play comes through, they move the puck nicely, and they're able to capitalize on the extra man. Wow, he got that thing away so quickly. Waited for the pass, timed it perfectly, and then beats the goaltender.
San Diego's on the board. They lead it 1-0.
I can't believe this game's going to end 1-0. So that first goal gives you a head start into what I hope is a pretty offensive game.
From the left side, takes it at center. He grabs the puck here at the point. Quick feed to Sergachev. Shot! That one's off the blocker! San Diego's gained possession along the boards. Carries it across the line. Moves it to Suter. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Malkin. Weber's gliding the puck along the line. And too much traffic in front blocks that one. McDavid's got it to the side. DeBrincat's exploring options with the puck. The Spirit have gained control of the puck along the wall. Big hit. Moves it quickly over to McDavid.
Whoa.
Scores! That's two unanswered now.
They stayed right on it. Once they got that first one, they just pushed the pace of this. Now they get another. Well, he gets to walk into this and pound it by the goaltender. Nobody picks him up in the high slot. Goalie's not going to get many of these.
San Diego's lead now extends to 2 as they make their way back to center ice here.
Probably a little surprising. It's not more than 2, James. They've had the majority of shots on goal and the majority of the dangerous chances.
With possession along the wall. Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. Here's a short pass to Granlund. Directs it on over to Weber. Uses the boards with the bank pass. Looking to make something happen along the boards. With the stop. In the first period. The Wolves get a hold of the puck along the boards. Takes it across the blue line. Here's a chance, and there's the save. I have been looking forward to this one for a while, but coming up, period number 2, the one, the only, Snoop Dogg in the house. San Diego's got the lead here late in this first period. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. Moves the puck down low. One-time blast. Oh, an even better save. One of the biggest icons in hip-hop will join us coming up in period number 2. The D-O-double-G, Snoop Dogg, joins us in moments.
Hey, fans, time for our Heritage Club. We'd like to join our Insiders Club.
And while both teams get a refresher, we'll take one ourselves heading into the second period.
Join our Insiders Club today.
Second period action. I'll tell you what, when our producer told us that he was going to join us in the broadcast booth, I didn't believe it, but man, he is here right now.
Yes, I am.
The
right here.
There he is, ladies and gentlemen, Snoop Dogg.
Hockey world, what's up, y'all?
How you doing?
Man, I'm good, huh?
You always seem to break social media, or the internet for that matter, when you're involved in hockey. Are you surprised at the reaction you get around the game?
No, not really, because, you know, hockey's a sport that people really want to know about. And, you know, Snoop Dogg is the perfect guy to teach it to you. So when I get involved, they want to know more about it.
Tries to get it to Jones. Quick pass to Hall. They've got the defense outnumbered. Snaps one on net. Stopped by the goaltender. Great reflexes, another save.
He worked hard to find the puck, but it's also because he's in great position. Rantanen's able to get everything behind this hit.
San Diego's got the lead here early in this second period. They're off. The frozen biscuits dropped, and we are back underway here. Attack. And down he goes as the puck goes free. Moves it around along the half wall. Broken up with a little physicality. Rantanen's lugging the puck. Feeds the puck to Doughty. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. Thunder Bay's got the puck along the wall. Puts it on net. Denies him! Quick feed to Heiskanen.
You've been around the league. You've traveled around the world. You must meet some of these athletes. Do you know some NHLers?
Yeah, I know a couple of them, man. You know a few friends of mine happen to play in the NHL. P.K. Subban. What up, P.K.? My main man, Sid the Kid. That's my favorite player. But, you know, me and Sid got a nice love for each other. Every time we see each other, we shake hands and bump fists and do what we do. And he do what he does. I does what
all
I
love.
Do. Come on, man. 87, man. You know what I'm talking about? I'm a big fan of Ovechkin, too, and I've been loving him for years, and the goalie Quick from the Kings, he's special.
You celebrated cups with the Kings.
I mean, they let me drink, man. I mean, what was I supposed to do, man? Me and Stanley got to understand it. Hey, Stanley.
If you were commissioner for a day, what would you do?
I would make all hockey games start off with some hip-hop music. I would have a great halftime performance, and the games would be more interactive as far as finding ways to put the people involved, not put them on the ice, but just make it more about the people. Like when I watch other sports, I feel like the fans are more involved. So finding ways to create ways to make it all about everybody involved, the players, the fans, and the people watching at home.
Like how?
Just put some Snoop on it, you know? That's what I do.
I can get down with that.
Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, he is the one and only Snoop Dogg. I don't know if you got to get going, but you want to watch the rest of the period up here with us?
If I can order us a couple of drinks, I'd love to stay up here with you.
I will not discriminate against
ordering. Hey, bring the drinks up here. I'm going to be up here for a minute.
The Wolves scoop it up along the boards. Drouin's carrying it ahead. Sends it over. A cannon from the point, and he comes up with the save. Picked up along the boards by Heischer. Gets that puck back on a stick. Moves it to Drouin. Hammers one from the point. Oh, wow! What a save with the glove! More than half the period has expired, and it's a 2-0 hockey game. Puck is dropped, and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Moves it quickly over to McDavid. Here's the pass! And he scores!
Don't you drop it in the bucket like that. He just dropped it in. Drop it in the net.
Drop it like it's hot, if you will.
Yeah, please believe. Drop it like it's hot.
Oh, what an effort. He did everything he could to stop that, but he gets beat anyway.
Shown no signs of letting up here in the back half of this second period.
The coaches just talked to them about not taking their foot off the pedal. Keep pushing till the end of the period.
Weber's got it across the line. Alex DeBrincat. And by number 71. And takes the puck into the corner of the offensive end. Here's a blast! And that's blocked. Takes the puck along the boards. Here's a blast! Oh, you would have had that, Ferraro.
Not really. I mean, I think I tried the same shot, but you don't hit the net. You don't give yourself a chance.
Absolutely.
See, that's when defense becomes offense.
Wow.
Checked him.
Checkmate.
Yeah, that's a check. Sign that check. Put my name on the check. Thank you. Check in, check out.
You're good at this.
Gensel's still trying to shake off the effects of this hit. He really took a thump there. Gensel's not on the bench anymore. He's gone down the tunnel towards the locker room where he'll be looked at by team doctors.
Well, that complicates things, Ray, as that'll shorten the bench here. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Here's a short pass to Konechny, and that one's broken up. Myers got it on the offensive end. Quick pass to Hall. Sends the pass over. Oh, what a stop! San Diego's got control of the puck. Fires it into the offensive zone. Thunder Bay's got the puck along the boards. And now it's over to Meyer. Here they are on the attack. And he easily stops that one.
We'll get a look at that crushing hit again. Right along the board, he finishes right through the player.
Here in the late going of the frame, 3-0 is where we sit. One team really enjoying this night. The other, not so much. Puts it on net.
Give me a hug, man. Love is love.
Love is love.
When the goaltender gets into the butterfly, he's just trying to take away as much of the net as he can. He's got lots covered, not enough as he gets beaten for a tally.
Thunder Bay's got something to build on here as we approach the third period, Ray.
Give them a little chance as they trail in this game, but man, they've got to be a lot better.
Face off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway.
Number 91, Taylor Hall.
Receives the pass.
Joe Pavelski. And by number 98, Mikhail Sergachev.
Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. Unleashes a cannon. Denies him with a save. He is a treasure, everybody. The one and only Snoop Dogg. Third period action is coming up, and it's coming up next. 3-1 is where things stand as both teams take a breather heading into the third.
Hey, fans, be sure to get your season tickets now at this year's playoff locations and prices. The regular season ticket price.
The third period is just around the corner. Ray and I will bring you all the action in a moment.
Section 144 on the concourse.
Welcome back, everyone. Both teams lined up at center. this third period. Here we go. Put up or shut up for both teams here in this third period. We are underway. 40 minutes into this one here, Razor, how do you see things?
Thunder Bay's been a step slow almost all game. They haven't had the puck very much. They're losing. If that's going to change, they've got to get the puck and hold on to it much more.
Jones has it along the boards. A howitzer makes the save on the slapper. And he slides it quickly to Jones. Sends a pass over. Big time stop there. San Diego's got a hold of it along the wall. Malkin's picking up steam. Tried to make a move and the puck hops away.
We used to call this the tic-tac kaboom. Nice move, but all of a sudden you don't have the puck.
Nice pass. Unleashes a cannon. Turns it away on the slap shot. The Spirit have taken possession along the wall. Brings the puck into the offensive end now. Oh, he'll feel that one. Doughty's got it along the boards. Takes the pass. Put it off the post.
Thunder Bay's only looking for something to go right. Get themselves back in this contest. But this hits the goalpost, and the score remains unchanged.
Slides the puck over. The one-time blast. Brilliant save. Read it perfectly.
He clearly thought he had room to get by, but it got closed off in a hurry. He took a big hit there.
Thunder Bay's got to be frustrated with how things have played out tonight, trailing in this third period. Granlund's won a big draw on their own end. Here they come on the attack. Makes his presence known on the ice. Let's one go with the stop. Finds some space in the corner. Quick feed to Sergachev. Back at the point, they set it up. Here he is in front. Oh, great glove save. Where'd that come from?
Right from the most dangerous area on the ice. The goalie flashes the glove. That's an arrogant stop. I wanted to get another look at this one, James. This looks like it hurts. I'm glad I'm in a suit here.
Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. 3-1 is where we're sitting. Fans being treated to a lot of offense thus far. Puck picked up by Heiskanen. Carries the puck through the neutral zone. Knocks the puck loose after a solid hit. With some momentum driving towards the net. And he makes the save. And it's kicked away. And it's a quick pass to Subban. That's a solid hit. Tatar's got it into offensive territory. Moves it to Rantanen. San Diego's got a hold of it against the wall. On the attack along the boards. And that's broken up. Into the offensive end now. Shoots it. Comes up on the blocker save. Here's a shot. And that one's blocked. Moves with the puck at the corner. Penalty coming up here as the play is stopped. Pretty easy call to make for hooking right here.
Well, he gets a stick around his waist, then he stops skating. It's almost like he's advertising for the penalty.
The Wolves get their man advantage unit out there for the first time tonight.
Here's their first power play of the night, James, and they can be patient on it. They want to get the good shot, not just start firing puck after puck at the net.
And another stop, trying to get it down the ice. And they do just that.
I thought they did a pretty good job there, James. That's a time you can get yourself running around in the zone. They didn't get there.
Takes it across the blue line. Moves the puck. Lets it go. Makes the save. More than half the period has gone by. Hope you're enjoying this one. It's a 3-1 hockey game. Lots of offense already. Heischer's won the draw. Here's a chance. Blocker save. A chance to get it out of the defensive zone. And that's a big clear at this stage of the game.
Yeah, they're all big now. That puck's near the blue line. It's got to get out.
Jostling for the puck, but still moves away. Carries it in. Takes the feed. Denied by the goaltender. That'll do it for the man advantage. Phenomenal penalty kill performance on that one.
Sometimes a power play is more critical than others. Lots of pressure on that five-man group. They didn't get it done, though. They missed it a really important time.
Thunder Bay's had more shots on goal, but yet they've run into a hot goalie. They trail late in this third period. Pavelski's won it off the faceoff. Through center along the wing. Moves it quickly over to Pavelski. To his teammate. Winds up, lets it go. Oh, just wide.
Right in his wheelhouse. He powders it, but just misses.
Skates in behind the cage. Jones has the puck against the half wall.
I love the way they played this shift. They protected the puck well, but now they've got it and they can run around the zone. The defenders can't chase them. They're too tired.
Thunder Bay's offensive struggles have been the story tonight. Lots of chances, just not a lot of results. Offensive zone faceoff and he wins the draw. Gets in front of it. Here in the late goings of the period, it's a two-goal lead we're looking at with the score 3-1. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Here's a short pass to Heischer. San Diego's gained possession along the boards. Oh, that's tremendous poise in the defensive end to break off the pass. The sense of urgency has really set in. They pulled the goalie, the extra attacker's out. Over the line they come, taken by Radulov. Great pressure forcing the turnover.
The Wolves can...
He scores! That's Mikko Rantanen!
Oh, with the goalie crowding over on the bench now, they finally punch through. Good work to get to the puck, retrieve it. Finally, they put it into the net.
Deficit suddenly doesn't seem so insurmountable now.
You can almost see the difference in the bench and the body language. They know they've got a chance.
Handles the puck. Dobrinkit has got it in the offensive zone. Forces the turnover.
19 minutes, 17 seconds.
And now he moves it to Subban. Strong use of the body. They desperately need a goal. The net is empty and the extra attacker's out. The Wolves gain control of the puck against the wall. Takes the feed. Sends the pass over. From out of nowhere, what a stop! Thunder Bay's running out of time. They need to find a goal here quickly as they trail late in the third. Off the draw, and he ties up his opponent. To the empty net and breathe.
I got two of these in my career. I was never out at the end of the game.
You had 400 goals and only scored two empty netters?
Yeah, when we were protecting the lead, it was safest with me sitting down.
What an indictment.
Oh, yeah. They'd really have to screw this up now, James, to lose. The empty netter should put it away.
To their lead with the empty netter, and Ray, that's pretty much all she wrote, I would say.
Well, you grind away to get the lead through this much of the game, and they pull the goalie, they're going to pressure you. You put it away with an easy one into the empty net.
And he makes the save with ease. And there's the final horn, putting a bow on this one here this evening.
They went for the tie by getting the goaltender out of there, and as a result, they end up giving up the empty netter. So while the final score is 2, it was really a close game.
Yeah, that's the one thing. When you look at the initial score, it'll look like a dominant victory, but this one wasn't decided until very...
For my broadcast partner, Ray Ferraro, my name is James Cebulski. Thanks so much for joining us. Good night.